Good morning. Those of you who saw my last night's video know where I'm at. I've discovered another colonial pit over here. And we'll go ahead and we'll see what's in it. Now, we know that this is a 1600s to early 1700s area because we've got several Spanish cobs on both sides of this road and real close to each other, and a 1721 Spanish Real right over here, and two cobs right over here in this field right here. And you can see where I dug one of them out up the front here. And then the other new pit's coming up back in the back where you see my stakes at. We'll walk over here just for a second, just kind of get a preview. But this is where one of the cobs was dug out. Another cob was found right not far away from here. And we got this new pit coming here. I really believe this field is loaded with stuff. You can see the shells and all that came out of that pit. Brits is loaded with Brits in there. Now this new one we got coming out here now. Just got started on it. It got the shells and all the good stuff coming out of here. Bones. This whole set of teeth bones. And also actually as you got, look at this. Nice piece of pottery. 1700s probably. And a piece of glass. So we're gonna get started here in just a little bit and see what we can come up with. Alright, let's get our gear together. It's not the best day here today. It's caused rain all day, but I couldn't wait. We got to get in here and see what we got. All right, stand by. Okay, here we go. Look at this. Bones. Lots of bones. I just kind of took the top layer off here. Trying to see what we got here. I just saw. Wow, what is that? Is that a brick or is that a rock? Not sure. Oh, look at this. Whole layer of bones. Look at this. Yeah. It's definitely an old cooking pit. Oh, look. Oh, we got some special find. A pipe stem from the 1600s. Check it out. Sweet. That's awesome. Uh-oh. Some pottery. A little bit of pottery. Look at that. All right, we're starting to find a few items. We're going to kind of go through here nice and slow. All right, here we go. Oh, look at this. What is this? Very strange looking. Look. What is that? I don't know what that is, but I'm starting to take a little time through here because I'm hitting a lot of cool stuff in here. What in the world is kind of big? Almost looks like coral. An oyster shell. Oyster shell. I don't know what this is, though. It's got me curious now. All right. Here's bone. Animal bone. Oh, here we go. What is that? That's a piece of coral. What is a piece of coral doing in the bottom of a pit? That is ocean coral. That is a strange find right there. Man, I don't know what that is. Why it's in here? Here we are, still in the pit. A colonial pit. Finding a piece of coral. Alright, let's see what else we got down in here. Oh, there's a piece of pottery. A small piece of pottery. Not much, but it's a start. It's a start. We are into a colonial spot. More bone. Oh, look. It's a pipe stem from the 1600s. That is definitely 1600s pipe stem. They actually can tell by the age from the size of the opening. We'll check that out when we get home. But, man, I am crazy about that. Thinking about that coral in here. I cannot believe a piece of coral. Anybody understand why a piece of coral would be in a colonial pit? Let me know. Well, that was in this area right here, so I'm kind of interested to see what else I'm going to find here. Man, we're starting to find some good stuff in here, though. Yeah. I can't imagine what might be in here. Still a lot of animal bones and stuff. Here we are. Oh, look at this. Look. Look at that. What is that? What is that? I don't know what that is. What to put over here to check it out. We are coming up. Lots of bones in here. A lot of bones. And they're kind of falling apart from age, I guess. I can't imagine us not finding a pipe stem. I mean, a whole pipe bowl in here eventually. I would say we should definitely find a pipe bowl. I've already found several of the pipe stems there. What we got here? And the other one. Oh, look at that piece of glass. We're always looking for glass. We love seeing the glass. You know, it might be a whole bottle in here from old stuff. Alright. You know, as you see, it's only a foot down. So we're not very deep. Look at that. Another jawbone. Another jawbone. Another animal. They've been cooking some animals in here. I don't know how far this one's going to go out. As you can see, it is full of stuff in here. Uh-oh. More glass. It's just pieces right now. But it's kind of muddy in here. I mean, it's kind of wet. I don't know how good a sifter would work in here today, but I see some more bones right there. I mean, some more teeth right there. See that? Teeth. I'm still perplexed over that coral. That's really got me questioning that. He's a tusk right here, I believe. I'm not sure. But, alright, I tell you what, I'm gonna cut the camera off a minute. Kind of get some of this cleaned up out of here and see what we can come up with. Alright. Can't wait to see if we can find some more pipe stems. Oh, there it is. Look. There's another pipe stem. Sweet. That is awesome. What else are we going to find? I love it. Alright, stay tuned. Alright, keep your eyes open for pipe bowls or stems. We're still coming through a lot of bones. A lot of bones. You see that? Oyster shells. Oh, there's another piece of pottery. Nice piece of pottery. We'll say that. Look at this. All in here. It's just constantly in here. Look at that. I just don't want to break anything. What's that? I don't know what that is. Hitting some nails and stuff in here too. I guess where they had a structure around it. This little cooking pit or whatever. I don't want to. Oh, look at it. Oh, no, that's an oyster shell. Thought it might have been a piece of pottery. Alright. I'm still perplexed over that. That right there. Coral. What in the world? Where did that come from? Anyway, we're still hitting a lot of charcoal in here. They've been cooking. A few pieces of brick, not much. A few pieces of brick, not a whole lot. Like in the other hole. I'd love to find some more pipe stems, though. That would make me know that they were in here smoking and maybe dropping some stuff down. Get some of this stuff out of here. That bone just comes, like, falls apart in your hands. Look at that. See the charcoal, the bone right there. They've been doing some cooking. Look at that. Definitely doing some cooking down here. Alright. Oh, there's one in it. Yep, that's a pipe stem. Look at that. Nice. Alright. So if they're dropping the pipe stems, maybe they're dropping coins. This last, that other pit, I did find a old 1600s cob in the very bottom of it. And no telling how many I missed. Because you get in here and get all these nails in here and it can hide your hit. Wow, another pipe stem. Sweet. Man, I don't know how big this thing goes. Looks like it's going a ways. But I'm not finding any whole bottles, that's for sure. Just some little tiny scrap pieces. What is that? Is that a pipe stem? Yep, another pipe stem. They were definitely in here smoking and cooking and eating and drinking. And So no telling what we might find. Alright, let's keep digging. Alright, as you can see, I kept going one direction to see if I got to the edge of this particular pit. Now, it looks like I have. I don't see anything else in here going this way. Nothing else at that layup level. I don't see anything, do you? Anybody see anything? I think we've hit the edge of it going this direction. But we still got some in this direction. But I think we're getting close to the edge of it. It's going to go up behind us. What I like to do is start filling it back in. Don't have to dig out anymore. But we're kind of hitting the edge here on this edge too, I think. I think we're hitting the edge over here. I think we're getting to the edge. It looks like it's going right along this edge right here. But back this way right here, it's done. Nothing else in here. I don't see nothing else in here. So, we'll start working this edge around. And that way we can be on the outside edge of it and then work our way through the middle. Just some oyster shells, charcoal. But I think that's the edge of it right there too, on this direction. I don't see anything else too much there. Alright, we're starting to get into something here, so looks like we're going to come right around this edge. We'll go as far as well as we can, and we'll start working back in. I know I got it on this edge here. So we can take this dirt here and pile in here, as long as we're satisfied there's nothing else in here. I'm going to dig this out and make sure one last time, but I think that's the direction we're headed. All right, looks like we found the edge going right along there. I see nothing else. I also found Beetlejuice. Look at him. Buried down here. We also find some pieces of pottery. Small pieces. Half parts glazed and parts not. That's kind of like the other piece I found in the other hole. Alright, I'm going to clean all this out so I can start filling it back in that way. That way we can keep working our way. I see a little bit of stuff right there. I'll make sure that doesn't continue over, but I think that's it. Alright, looks like it kind of played out on this left side all the way around me now. It's playing out fast as it started almost. Still got some good stuff coming out of here though. Still, look at that. Still got lots of bones in here, so we definitely got some potential activity here. And got another pipe stem. But looks like it played out going that way. So, we just have to keep working out. Look at that black. They've been cooking some meat. It's like an oyster shell. Yep, oyster shells are stacked in here, so maybe it kind of continues this way, hopefully. It's kind of played out behind us, so we'll start taking this and put it on top of it. Although, a big pile of dirt's here, so we're going to move it back here, too, because we're going right underneath of it. All right, so get your shovels out and give me a hand. All right, looks like this is the closest to a pipe bowl I've come. Look at that. It's the very base of a pipe bowl. Look at that. Isn't that sweet? That is a pipe bowl's stem, right? The very base of the bowl. 1600s. Cool. Maybe early 1700s. That is sweet. Alright. We're still going in here and still got some good stuff, looking stuff here. So let's keep looking. Alright, I worked my way all around this edge. Found another, some more pipe stems and some pieces of pottery, little tiny pieces of pottery, some other oyster shells and stuff, but it looks like I've about played this one out. Fast as it comes, it goes. But I did find some right cool stuff in here, though. No coins yet, and the reason why I started digging this pit was because I had a nice 80s, in it, which is kind of represents silver, which could be a Spanish cob in here, but it could be being masked by some of the steel in here, too. I don't know. Well, I'm still keep looking at around that, but one of the coolest things was this. A giant piece of coral in the hole. Why would they have coral here? That is the strangest thing I've ever seen. Like you say, still got a lot of nails, old iron nails, bones. I just picked a few of them up. Shells, pipe stems, and some pieces of pottery and stuff over here. That's about it for this one, I think, though. But pretty cool, though. Enjoyed digging it out. I hope y'all enjoyed it. You never know, though. You might find a bird glass mason jar full of coins from the 1600s. Who knows? That's what I'm looking for, some treasures. I know you are too. All right, stay tuned. We're going to keep getting up, see what we can find. And if we don't get anything else in this, we're going to head out and start probing around some more. Thanks for watching.
This is something cool. I'll let you dig this. Come here and look. Another piece of that pottery.
All right. Well, that was awesome digging that last pit. And so started messing right here. Jane, my buddy James came out here and started doing the rod right there. And he hit a little hard surface. And we started going down. And sure enough, another hole full of stuff. Look at this. Still, oh, so he's got something. Go ahead and dig that out, Jane. What is that? Looks like a piece of a cut pottery or something, maybe. Yeah, oh, okay. It looks like it's coming up now. Yeah, big old chunk of
like crock or something.
Oh man, 1600 pottery. That's awesome. Yep, some kind of pot. Anyway, looks like we're getting to it some more. So we're gonna start digging this one out. See what we can come up with.
We did dig the full pipe stem pieces out of
there. Oh yeah, you did get already got a pipe stem out of there. Yep, still digging, and they'll tell what we're gonna find. Hopefully a few Spanish cobs, maybe. All these pits seem to be the same. Oyster shells, bones, pipe stems, nails. Got a few nails in here too. And once in a while we get a Spanish cob. You see these big old chunks of bone. They just rotted out, didn't they? And it just like turns to dust. Sometimes they just right out. Now these holes here have not had the brick in it like that one hole I had. It was just filled full of brick. But this one doesn't seem to have that, but we all getting a pile of stuff. Got that one piece of pottery, but no whole pieces yet, but we're getting there. Alright. James still digging here. And we're still getting lots of oyster shells. What is that right there? No, nothing there.
There's something big right there.
Oh, big old
yeah,
spike.
Look at that big old spike.
Yeah, that's a spike. Yeah, that's a big spike, square spike. That's awesome. Nice. Sweet. Look at all this stuff. I think this whole field is full of it. There's my other two pits right there. The other pit right behind me. I think you can dig anywhere in here and find these things. Look at the bone coming out here. More bone coming out.
Everywhere. Yeah, it seems like the pipe stems are higher, and then you get to the shell, and then you get to the bone. It's like it's in layers. I don't know if that's the natural settle rate or...
Oh, it's trap. I mean, you know they ate those oysters, but in the bones, I don't know. It's still just coming out. There's lots of oyster shells here. Lots of them. All right. James and I are still working on this one. It seems to have petered out to the left over this side, but we're heading back this way, and it still seems to be some...
What is this?
...stuff in here. There's still iron. Oh, piece of brick. Haven't been finding a whole lot of brick in here, but maybe we're heading toward a better area here. Still found about five pipe stems.
There's your teeth.
And some teeth. Yep, still finding bones and teeth and shells. Anyway, we're going to keep working this way. Hadn't found that elusive Spanish cob yet. Well, it's probably here. All right, let's keep moving on. All right, I think we've done another pit. There's the last one, and this one here. Lots of bone shell, same thing. Got lots of pipe stems this time. Must have 10 pipe stems and pieces of pottery. But we're going to call this one a day, I think. I know it's more in here, though. You know it. We're going to hit the mother load one of these days with the old bottles and the coins in it. All right, we're going to wrap this one up. All right, here's a picture of the pipe bowl stems I found today. And James also found probably another 6 or 7. And started doing a little bit of research, trying to figure out the date on them. So here's a little scale that they use to tell the dates of pipe bowl stems. And depending on the size of the hole in them, depends on the date. And these seem to be right around 664, which would put that site at a 1680 to 1720 site, which is pretty cool. So that's why we're finding those old Spanish cobs and all in there. So anyway, we're going to keep searching the site and see if we can't find something else. There's got to be some more in there, so stay tuned.